Hi everyone, in this video I will show you how to calculate Cronbach's alpha to assess the construct reliability. As mentioned in the video regarding reliability assessment, Cronbach's alpha is one of the most popular methods being used to evaluate the reliability of constructs. In this example, we will calculate Cronbach's alpha with HBET dataset. In order to calculate Cronbach's alpha to evaluate the construct reliability using SPSS, we select Analyze from the menu and select Scale, then choose Reliability Analysis from the list. It opens up the Reliability Analysis window. As you can see here, SPSS has many options for reliability analysis, but we use alpha for the purpose of reliability assessment. Another method of evaluating the reliability is to use construct reliability score, which will be covered in DAV 724. The exploratory factor analysis indicated several factors and corresponding items. Let's examine one factor, customer service factor, which consists of three items, H9, complaint resolution, H16, order and billing, and H19, delivery speed. We select these variables and move them to the items box on the right. We'll be using Cronbach's alpha to evaluate the reliability of this factor. Note that we run the reliability analysis for one factor or one construct at a time, then repeat the process with other factors. We click Statistics button, and we need to check two important boxes, Scale if items deleted, and Correlation. Click Continue, and click OK. SPSS show the results of the reliability analysis. The first one and also important one that we need to look at is the Cronbach's alpha value shown under reliability statistics. In this case, the Cronbach's alpha is 0.897. As mentioned before, a Cronbach's alpha of 0.7 or higher indicates good reliability. In this example, we can conclude that we have good construct reliability. We also need to look at other results. First, the inter-item correlation matrix shows the intercorrelation among items. It appears that these items are highly correlated. Next, we need to look at item total statistics. In this table, we examine the column called corrected item total correlation. All items are expected to be highly correlated to the total. This column shows the correlation between a single item and the summated scale or total scale. The cutoff value of 0.3 should be used when examining this value. Any item that has an item total correlation less than 0.3 should be concerned and might even need to be removed. In this example, all items have very high item total correlation. Another column needs to be examined is Cronbach's alpha if item deleted. This shows the Cronbach's alpha value if a specific item is deleted. For example, if we delete item X9, then Cronbach's alpha will be 0.844. If we delete X16, then Cronbach's alpha will be 0.864, etc. The purpose of this column is to allow us to examine whether deleting an item will improve the Cronbach's alpha. So we compare these values with the overall Cronbach's alpha up there, which is 0.897. We see that deleting any of these items will not improve the Cronbach's alpha. Typically, if we have a good Cronbach's alpha value, we do not need to delete any item, even though this action will improve the overall Cronbach's alpha. If the overall Cronbach's alpha is not satisfactory, we can use this information to improve the score Again, deleting any item from a factor must be considered carefully because it will affect the factor structure and lead to losing information. One more point about Cronbach's alpha. If you receive a negative Cronbach's alpha, it means some items are not measured in the same direction, which causes negative correlations. The solution is to reverse these items, but this creates more work and in some cases will affect hypothesis testing. I would strongly suggest avoiding this situation when you design the questionnaire. Make sure all items are measured in the same direction. This is how to conduct reliability analysis using SPSS. Thank you and bye now.